Hello and welcome to this first video tutorial. This is about 3D modeling concepts and terminology. I'm going to try to make these videos short, simple, and focused to give you just the basic information that you need. The goal of this class is limited to learning how to model and texture low polygon artwork in Maya. So we're not going to get into a lot of detail about the other things that Maya can do, including animation, physics, and so forth. This is just going to be about low polygon modeling and texturing. So you can see I've got a character here that is not finished, but that I'm working on. And if I select her, I can see the mesh, and it is not very high polygon. It could be much more dense in terms of how many polygons it has. What is a polygon? Polygon is a two-dimensional shape that exists here, in this case, in three-dimensional space. So the simplest polygon is a three-sided one, which is a triangle. You can also have squares and rectangles and trapezoids, other four-sided objects. You might have a five-sided or a six-sided polygon. I try to keep things simple, keep them as triangles or squares. I usually have better luck texturing when I do that and making things look the way I want them to look. So a polygon is really just a shape. It means many angles, so it can be any number. We can also model in 3D using curves or splines, or in the case of Maya, they're called NURBS, N-U-R-B-S, and we may talk about those a little bit, but the focus of our unit here is going to be on polygonal or polygon modeling. Okay, so an object existing in three-dimensional space, like this character, is an example of a node. A node is something that is in your scene in 3D space. This character is a special kind of node. It's a 3D mesh, which is geometry, object geometry in your scene. Other nodes include lights, like this little light here. I'll zoom in on it. Well, it's hard to see. Cameras. We've got a camera in the scene on her. You can also have groups that are considered a node. And you can have dummy objects that are just like placeholder, that they're useful for certain functions. But these other objects, these other types of nodes, don't show up when you render the scene. The geometry, the mesh, and the particle effects and things in your scene will show up when you render them. But other objects are invisible because they're useful, but we don't want to see them in the scene, like the cameras and so forth. Okay, so that's what nodes are, N-O-D-E-S. I mentioned groups. I may be able to create primitive objects here, new meshes, new objects, and then group them together. I can select these two and command group them on my Macintosh. So now they are a group. If I hit the up arrow key, there'll be a group. I can also create parent and child relationships between objects. So if I have a cylinder and a cone here, and I select the cylinder first and then the cone, shift select the cone, hit P for parent, now the cone is the parent of the cylinder, and if I move the cone, then the cylinder goes with it. If I just move the cylinder, the child, it goes by itself. But since the cone is the parent, the child has to follow the parent around. So that'll be a way of organizing your scene. We'll get into that in more detail later. So we also have what's called rendering, which we will talk about a little bit later in detail, but that's when you take a highly detailed view of your scene, and the software can output a two-dimensional rendering of the scene with lights and shadows. Okay, there's also the concepts of rigging and animation, which we won't get into in this class much, but anyway, animators move the objects around, they animate things. So this character, in order to be animated, she would need what's called a rig, which is a set of simple bones that I would put in this mesh and assign the bones to different parts of the mesh so that we could move that character. So this character has not been rigged, and as a result is not going to be easily animated until we rig the character. Right? Now you saw I just changed the rendering modes. We'll show how to do that later, but you can view things as wireframe, shaded, flat shaded, or textured. So this is a textured version, and I've got my lights, the default lights on there. So when I started, she had no lights on. Anyway, that's a quick overview of some concepts, some basic concepts that you'll need. And in the The next few videos will get into detail about these things one by one and other things that you'll need to know about Maya.